And we're back. You're watching Sport Federation TV. I'm Lenyukta Chetty. And we've been experiencing some hectic weather in the Western Cape region with all this heat. And from a sport that actually would enjoy this weather and favor this weather, we have from surfing, Bruce Anderson and Brandon Benjamin. Welcome, gentlemen. Thank you for joining us. I know you'd probably rather be at the beach, but we've got to tell the world what's the exciting news in surfing is currently. And now, Brandon, you are competing in this sport. How did you get involved?
I was first a skater, and then they came to my school, which is Musenberg Junior, Roxy Surf School and Lifestyle, and then I got involved there, and then since that, I've been surfing.
Yeah, and how many years now have you been involved?
It's been 12 years now since I've been surfing.
12 years?
12 years, yes.
Okay. Bruce, what is your involvement with the sport?
More on the administration side. I do still surf a little bit competitively with other guys with wheelchairs and crutches. But yeah, it's more my role is primarily on the administrative side. I'm the treasurer of Western Province Surfing, and I'm also a director of Surfing South Africa. Mm. And it's surfing's always been a passion of mine. It's done a lot for me in terms of having been such a strong interest. I've been to places that I wouldn't have otherwise have gone to, and sort of traveled to a lot of different places that have been really interesting. So it's
yeah,
been great.
It must be so awful going to all the beautiful beaches in all over the world, hey?
Yeah, no, we've Brandon and I, not that we went together, but you know, we've struggled in places like Reunion and various places. I've been to Indonesia. I've surfed in Europe.
Wow.
I've surfed in the US. So yeah, it's been great. It's really good.
Yeah. Brandon, you said you used to skate,
yeah,
and then you got drawn to surfing. How did the bug bite you?
It was just something very different, you know. With skating, it was the same thing every time, and with surfing, it was always something different, something new. It was never the same day out there, you know. So for me, it was just something that's new, something that's challenging, and something that can never be perfected, I personally think. So.
Yeah. There's always that next limit, hey?
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's limitless, and I like to be limitless. So.
Yeah, and I think about all the amazing movies, the big budget movies and stuff that's made about surfing, and it seems unreal, that kind of fitness level and that euphoria that a surfer must experience when they're, gliding? Is it gliding?
I don't think that's a word that comes up too
surfing.
Often.
Surfing is the word.
Yeah, surfing's the right word, basically, when you're riding the wave, surfing.
Yeah. Western Province Surfing is probably quite a big organization in terms of numbers and compared to the other districts. What kind of development efforts are there currently to get new surfers, new young surfers involved?
It's quite interesting. Yeah, we are, I think we are, you know, unashamedly, I think that we are recognized as being probably the most developed in terms of transformation in the country, and I think a lot of that has to do with the fact that we were quite early on board in getting some funding from Lotto, probably about 8 or 9 years ago, which we don't have anymore, but it gave us that push where, with working with Surfing South Africa, we've got this competition called a grommet competition, so we run trials, and I think Brandon came through that. His first experiences were probably in that area. Mm. And then we also have very good relationships with a lot of the NGOs, the guys that use surfing as a medium to, not just for surfing, but also to help the kids sort of develop their social skills and to sort of enjoy getting away from the difficulties of the environments that they come from.
Mm.
So it's, you know, we've got to accept that the environment that we live in is needs
complex,
to be inclusive of other people and give them the opportunity, and so where we can. So as I say, there are a lot of programs, there are a lot of potential opportunities, but they're never enough. So we certainly don't lack for opportunities or opportunities to try and work with people. Yeah.
Mm, mm. So are you competing on a national level now, Brandon?
Yeah, national.
National level.
Yeah, I'm currently SA champion.
Currently SA champion. You must do that. you must say it like it means something, because that's quite an accomplishment. I mean, you're competing with top surfers from all over the country. Hey.
Yeah, it was the South African Mercedes-Benz Championships held in the Hoendrief. Yeah, it was actually the open championships, and I was lucky to be the first person of color to actually win it, which was a privilege for me because now I've opened the doors for the other guys, you know.
Yeah,
it's good to see them come up the ranks.
And breaking a stereotype as well. Yeah. Hey, I mean, let's call a spade a spade. And that's great because it's going to encourage other people.
That's
from
what I'm about.
Yes, absolutely. So international events, do you have anything to look forward to?
So we have about 7 to 8 international events in South Africa. Mm-hmm. That happens. It's called the WQS. And in terms of that, I want to do them here. And then after that, I would like to go overseas. But in terms of funding, it's kind of hard in South Africa because the industry is quite down.
Yeah.
But I'm still waiting for funding to come on board. I have a fun page as well. So if anyone is, you know, just let me know. Facebook or Instagram.
All right. So. Okay. Well, we've got some footage of you surfing and we're going to share that with our viewers now. That, viewers, is why Brandon Benjamin is the South African champion in the Opens category for surfing. Amazing, hey? When you came in here today and I asked you, would you rather be at the beach? You said, no, you don't like too many people on your beach. And on a day like this, everybody flocks there. What are some of the best surfing spots in the Western Cape?
For me, my favorite is definitely Cork Bay. It's quite a local break, you know, not many people can come there, so it's also cool like that.
Yeah.
But for me, it's mainly, that's definitely my favorite place. And then places like Dunes, The Hook, and Lindadno. So this, for Cape Town, there's a large scale, you know, of surf breaks, and they're all beautiful. I mean, Cape Town's beautiful. So
yeah.
Wherever the best spot is that day, that's definitely where I'm going.
So what are some of the challenges that you experiencing with realizing these projects that you have for development?
Look, as a small sport, I think one of the drawbacks is we've been around in Cape Town for as Western Province Surfing, Cape Town Surf Riders, for close to 50 years, but we still don't have a clubhouse. We don't have a permanent home, which is always a drawback. We don't have any employees, so you're all based on volunteers, and putting a good committee together is always a difficult challenge. It often centers around one or two people or two or three people, and it's a lot of work, and guys can get burnt out quite quickly. And then there's the funding challenge, which is, to realistically really give the guys, the people with potential, the opportunities to introduce new people to the sport. It's one thing to say, come down to Musenberg, we'll lend you a board and you can have a quick surf. But if that kid lives 20 kilometers away, we've got no way of getting them to the beach. We don't have transport. If we need to get somebody up to an event, to send somebody up to an event in Mossel Bay or Jeffreys is expensive. Mm. And that's, we need those budgets for that. And the kind of money, as Brandon said, the industry's in a state of difficulty. They're more inclined to be product support as opposed to financial support. And, Brandon can't pay for a accommodation with a wetsuit. It doesn't work like that.
Yeah.
We do a lot of fundraising. We do try and professionalize and create a responsible image that will attract some sort of a corporate sponsor, and we work on that. And certainly Surfing South Africa has been successful in attracting in the last 2 years sponsors outside of the industry in the form of Mercedes-Benz and also Sea Harvest,
yeah.
who are very committed in Cape Town to development surfing. And yeah, we're looking to putting more programs together with them and hopefully have a long relationship.
Yeah, it's such a beautiful sport, exciting sport, and it can, I mean, we live in a country that's surrounded by ocean. It should be accessible to as many people as possible. Hey, Brandon, what would you say to any youngsters and not so young that are maybe interested in learning more about the sport?
That is definitely something that's new, something that's different, and something that's always challenging. So if you wanna be out there and be different, come surf, and it's a feeling that I can't explain. It can only be experienced, you know.
Yeah.
So yeah, come and let's grow the sport, because right now, currently, the development of the sport is growing, and just watching what it can do to transform their lives. I mean, you know, I'm sure everyone wants a transformation. So come out and surf for sure.
All right, excellent.
Great.
Thank you for joining us. And can people get in touch with you through your Facebook page?
Facebook page or website, but Facebook page is the one is most popular. Yeah.
Western Province Surfing.
Yeah.
Western Province Surfing.
For me, on Facebook or on Instagram, Brandon Surfs or Brandon Benjamin. Facebook.
Brandon Benjamin or Brandon Surfs.
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. And come back and share with us more news from your federation.
Okay, we'll do.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Okay. After the break, we'll be taking a look at highlights from the West Coast District Sports Awards. So please stay tuned for that.